Hello everybody and welcome back to our channel. Today's review is indeed special because we'll be reviewing the Aliant collection, not going onto the product to check all its features, but we'll be reviewing its 3D visual configurator, which is indeed a special feature of our website. So let's review it and dive in into all its features. We start by clicking on configure, and now the first screen with all the shared features, shared materials of the composition is being opened. We start from selecting a lacquer, and this will be applied to all parts. And now we are selecting, for example, a different lacquer for the back panels. And we start configuring. It loads, and we have a first column, which is preliminary uploaded. We change its width, so we reduce it by simply dragging. And now we change its height. And we adapt it to specific heights, so it can be custom made by the millimeter or adapted to its standard heights. Now we add a second column. We reduce it again in width, and we bring it down to be equivalent to the first one. We go back to selecting the first column, and we duplicate it, and we move it at the right. We align the elements versus snap feature so that it's automatically attached. And now we duplicated the second column, and we start beginning to see a composition, an actual composition. Now we select a corner element. This is a special corner. It's rarely used because there are not many rooms with this sort of corner. Okay, so we added a partition, a side partition. And now we select, we changed the side because we are building a corner bookshelf system, and we chose a bridge element. We widen it based to our liking, and we add the final shoulder, the final partition. And now we select how we want to set the lower part of the bridge. And for example, we position a desk, we raised it in height. And we select the back panels. And also we can adapt the way these back panels are joined. For example, here in the lower part could be open, but we chose, we could have a piano underneath the bridge. Now we have a desk with back panels. And we can change the specific finish of the panels. So we have our corner composition. And we modify and change the details of this first column. And we have just activated the option which allows us to modify in detail the column. We remove certain shelves. We deactivate the modifications for the column, and now we can easily add doors. Basically, when we select doors, we have this red layer which tells us where we can place that that door. Okay, now we are doing the same. We are removing shelves just the same way as we did with the first column. We must say that this is not a detailed tutorial, but is more a showcase of the Aliant collection and its 3D configurator. Now we are adding these additional doors, and we have these two identical columns. We even get to the tiny details of choosing where I want the handle or where I want the push-pull element in order to have easy opening. Because if it's a very high door, I will not have the push-pull up high, otherwise it would be difficult to reach. So we deactivate some more shelves. And we add glass doors. Inside the glass door, we add a glass shelf. And now we are choosing the color for the aluminium frame of the glass doors. And now we can duplicate the glass door straight away. So all its features are duplicated onto the additional glass door. So there are, of course, you can do the same things by repeating operations, or you can do things by actually duplicating certain items. Now we add tilting doors. With tilting door doors, I don't have to eliminate to take the inside the shelves off. And now we can see how all the doors are opened and closed. And we have our composition. And we can add it to the basket. And now we have its summary in the basket. We start with another composition. And we have the, okay, we can adjust the height of the whole composition with a snap feature. Now we select materials, and now it's a fashion wood, which is real wood, with back panel, with lacquered frames for the glass doors and lacquered back panels, okay? And we start configuring. Okay, we start with a standard column with the same height that we selected before. And we add a bridge element straight away. Now we switch to the 2D view to see it from above, and we actually can create walls around it. It's not needed. We can... Okay. And so you see that there are snap features so that a certain element can align to a wall. And now we move over the wall with a double side, two side elements, so that you see that it doesn't have back panels. And now we have selected the options to modify and detail a certain column, and we are removing shelves, we are repositioning partitions. You see, we said that this is not a detailed tutorial, but more of a showcase of the 3D configurator. But you can have hints, you can get hints about how to do things. So we have this first side on the left, which is against the wall, and this right side, the second side on the right, which is a two-sided bookshelf element. We deactivate the possibility of modifying in detail a certain column. Now we have these added shelves. Okay. And now we add glass shelves. And drawers. Of course, when I add elements on a two-sided bookshelf, I can add the door on the front, and there will be a flat fixed panel on the back, because on the other side, I will not be able to open the elements, but it will still be visible. Now I'm completing the bridge. And this is a specific element for TVs. You see that there's the cable element. Now I add drawers here as well. So you see very, very customized compositions. Tilting door there. And if you have a clear idea of what you want to get, you can actually move quickly. This video is not being sped up. It's the standard speed with which you can configure your custom bookshelf. Of course, you must know where to get items, so there's a learning curve. Now we have duplicated the glass door. And you see the beauty of this composition. Now we have all these the standard finishes that we selected before, and but we can change them on a specific item or on a set of items. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Sorry for my enthusiasm. And we can add it. It's completed. We can see how to open and close elements, and we can add it to the basket. And in the basket, we have a summary. It takes a few seconds to load. And we have a summary of our custom composition. We create another composition. We start by clicking on configure. And now we select, for example, the standard height of the composition with the snap feature so that it's based on standard heights. Now we select lacquers, but we can choose, select any material. And we can have the back panels with a different lacquer, for example. And these will be the standard materials and, for example, handles of all our composition. We start with a basic column in the height that we have already selected, and actually with the same depth that we selected at the start. We selected now, we added a second column, and now we change the width of the first column by pulling it. We activate the possibility of changing the details of the column, and we remove one shelf. Now that we have modified this column as we wish it, as we want it, we duplicate it and move it to the right of the composition, and we complete it with the right partition, which completes the composition. Now we start selecting doors, and we have a glass door here and a glass door here. And now we change the opening side. One is left and one is right. Now we add the drawers, and you see how easy it is to add drawers. Of course, the more you customize the composition, the more it takes by removing shelves, changing dimensions. But if you stay on standard solutions, it will be quicker. If you want something very much customized, it will be slower, I would say. Now we add these cabinets, these open cabinets. They are built with a different thickness of the panels than the standard 35 millimeters of the Aliant collection. We change their width, and we can move them. I can have all of them in the same color, or actually I could do different color. I could have different colors. Now, what we do is changing the finishes of the perimeter of the doors, of the glass doors. And we have our whole composition. It's more of a big sideboard, but it's very much customized and based on the bookcase collection, and we add it to the basket. And we have our summary here with our preview. So we've come to the end of today's product review. It has been a special review indeed, because it hasn't been shot in our showroom, but it is in this room, because we wanted to display all sorts of opportunities and features of our 3D configurator. It was not meant to be a detailed tutorial. While it's a mix between a tutorial and a showcase, I hope that you liked it. And see you next time. Bye-bye.